Sir, if male and female with their own consent they are having relations, sexual relations, then Islamic that Sharia law, what would be the punishment for
Yes. If
that?
they have with their consent that they become husband and wife, there's no problem at all. If you say with their consent to enjoy and corrupt the society, then Sharia law doesn't agree. If you say with consent, okay, I want to be a wife and to be a husband, no problem, no one can stop them. They can give the consent, no one can stop them. But if they say, okay, let us only enjoy, and then after that, no, then we'll keep on changing partners. This is common in the Western world. In our Eastern society, I wouldn't like my sister changing partners every second night. I would not like that. I would not like my wife going out with someone and changing partners. It is our culture. So the Western culture has actually corrupted the society. So that is the reason Islam doesn't believe. If you really want to spend life with consent, marry each other, no one can stop you. You marry your consent and stay together. If there's a problem, you can get divorced, you can marry someone else, no problem. But saying that without marriage we'll keep on changing partners, Islam doesn't agree in the corruption of the society. Therefore, I said that if you corrupt the society, then you should be punished. And this is there in all the religions, not only in Islam. Even
So what
Christianity
is the
doesn't agree.
punishment, Dr. Nayak? What is the punishment that a
Yes.
couple?
One more thing, that if someone does an adultery, the punishment is only there if you get four witnesses. If someone does adultery and we have no witnesses, then you cannot give any punishment to the person. If someone alleges that this lady is not good or this man is not good, he's been doing adultery, then you have to produce four witnesses. If you produce four witnesses, then in Islam, the punishment is stoning to death, which is there in many other religions also. It's not only in Islam, it is then Christianity, then Judaism also. You read the Bible, the one who does adultery should be stoned. It's not a new law, it's in even other religions, but they don't implement it, they don't follow it. But in Islam, you should have four witnesses. And if someone lays an allegation that this man and woman are doing adultery, and if he cannot produce four witnesses, he gets 80 lashes. Because many a time we keep on blaming people that this woman is not good, this man is not good. If you lay an allegation against a woman's chastity or modesty, according to Surah Nur, chapter number 24, verse number 4, and you cannot produce four witnesses, you get 80 lashes. That means you cannot, here in our society, you can abuse a woman, you can call her by any name and you walk through. In Islamic law, if you abuse a woman and call her something, and you cannot prove it, cannot produce four witnesses, 80 lashes. This is the protection she gets. In our society, whether it be in India or whether Western country, you can abuse a woman, you can abuse, they don't get away free. In Islamic law, if you lay an allegation against a woman's modesty, and lay an allegation that she's unchaste or she's immodest, if you cannot produce four witnesses, 80 lashes. So this again means that if someone does privately and gets away with it, he'll have no punishment here. He'll have punishment in the hereafter. Someone decides personally and does it, he's breaking the law of the Sharia. He's breaking the rule of the Creator. But here he won't get punishment because there are no four witnesses. He'll get the punishment in the hereafter. That is the reason never, 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 ever in any hadith of the sayings of the Prophet, in the history of Islam, talking at the time of the Prophet, at the time of companion, has any woman been stoned to death except she voluntarily said. She voluntarily came to the Prophet and said that I have committed adultery, give me punishment. Prophet said, go away. Again he come, again then the punishment was given. There is not at all, there is no hadith, sayings of the Prophet, that anyone was, allegation was laid against, somebody was punished. It was the woman herself repented. And she came to the Prophet and said, I've done adultery, please forgive me, punish me. Prophet says, go away. Again she comes. Then the Prophet puts the punishment. And then the Prophet said that the way she has repented, if you distribute in the whole city of Medina, it will make everyone pure. That means the Prophet praised her, that she did a sin, she repented, she came to the Prophet and told the Prophet, punish me so that I will get a better life in the hereafter. And then the Prophet first avoided, and then he executed the punishment and said that her repentance is accepted.
Dr. Nair.